Hello students, I am Dr. Naresh Chandanani from Jaipur Engineering College. In the last lectures, we had discussed the three cases for regular singular point. Today we are going to discuss the fourth and last case for solution in series for regular singular point. And this fourth case is roots of initial equation differ by an integer and make one coefficient indeterminate. First of all, we discuss the working rule. Suppose the initial equation has two unequal roots m1 and m2, where m1 is greater than m2. These are differing by an integer, and when we put m equal to m2, we get one solution. In this solution, two arbitrary constants will be present, a0 and another one. This another one constant remains indeterminate when we put m equal to m2. So we write the solution in the terms of two constants, a0 and the second one. In this case, the solution obtained by putting m equal to m1 will be rejected because it gives no independent solution. It is just a multiple of the solution obtained by putting m equal to m2. Here we have taken an example, x square d2y by dx square plus x plus x square into dy by dx plus x minus 9 into y equal to 0. So p0 is x square. Putting x equal to 0, p0 will also be 0. So x equal to 0 is a regular singular point. We can assume the solution as equation 2. We differentiate it and get dy by dx. Again differentiate, get d2y by dx square. We put second, third and fourth equations into first and we get the following equation. So after simplification of the previous equation, we will get equation 5. From equation 5, we equate to 0 the coefficient of x to the power m plus r. For this, we put r equal to 0 in the first term and we get a0 m plus 3 m minus 3 equal to 0, putting r equal to 0 here. So we get m plus 3 into m minus 3 equal to 0 because we know that a0 cannot be equal to 0. This gives m equal to 3 and minus 3. And now we equate to 0 the coefficient of x to the power m plus r plus 1. For this, go to equation 5. In the first term, you have to replace r with r plus 1 and you will get ar plus 1, m plus r plus 4, m plus r minus 2. In the second term, we have to put it as it is and we get ar m plus r plus 1 equal to 0. So equation 6 is the recurrence relation. Putting m equal to minus 3, we get ar plus 1 equal to minus r minus 2 upon r plus 1 r minus 5 ar. In this relation, in this recurrence relation, put r equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and we get a1 equal to minus 2 by 5 a0, a2 equal to minus 1 upon 8 a1. Again put the value of a1 here and we get 2 upon 40 a0. a3 will be 0 when we put r equal to 2, then a3 equal to 0. Due to a3, a4 will also be 0, and due to a4, a5 will also be 0. Now come to a6. This is very important step, see it carefully. When we put r equal to 5 in equation 6, when we put r equal to 5 in equation 6, we get the denominator as 0, and due to a5 was 0, the numerator also becomes 0. Numerator is 0 because a5 is 0 and denominator is 0 because r equal to 5. Hence a6 is indeterminate. So we will not express a6 in terms of a0, rather we will represent the remaining coefficients a7, a8, a9, etc. in terms of a6. So a7 is equal to minus 4 by 7 a6, a8 equal to minus 5 by 16 a7. Again put the value of a7 and you get a8 equal to 20 upon 112 a6 and so on. Now the solution is y equal to sigma ar x to the power m plus r. We have expanded this put m equal to minus 3 and take x power minus 3 common, we get equation 7 as the solution. So putting the values of all the coefficients, we get y equal to a naught x power minus 3, 1 minus 2 by 5 x plus 1 by 20 x square. And we have seen that a3, a4, a5 all are 0. Now come to this, a6 x cube into 1 minus 4 upon 7 x plus 20 upon 112 x square, and so on. Taking m equal to 3, we will get y equal to a naught x cube into 1 minus 4 by 7 x plus 20 upon 112 x 7. You can easily get this solution from above equation. Now this is a multiple of first solution. This is not any independent solution, so we will reject it. Here are some practice problems. You can solve them. If you feel any difficulty in this lecture, you can contact me on my email. Thank you, students. Have a good day.